So I'd asked a while back about the wildlife name, and since we have Dan Camp here with us too, I didn't know if you had anything to report on that, because when we talked about it out in Briceville, although I'm not sure that you were at the Briceville meeting.
I was there.
No, I mean the attorney.
Oh.
It was the other attorney, I think.
You know, I haven't spoken, to answer your question, I pumped it. I provided Dr. Lewis with the name of a attorney in the firm who specialized in intellectual property. With that being said, I'll turn it over to Dr. Lewis.
We actually have a draft of an agreement that was sent to us by Radium with regard to that, and so I've reviewed it. The attorney that Mr. Hackett referred me to, I talked with him and told him the situation, and he reviewed it with his firm, and he felt like that there was another attorney that would be more appropriate to review that particular agreement and to advise us in that regard. And I have not contacted that attorney yet, but I am in the process of working on that. So.
Dr. Fulmer, it is a very specialized area of law, and I think you and I have discussed it with regards to intellectual property. And as I indicated, there's a lot of area of laws I feel very comfortable with. This is not one of them, and so it doesn't surprise me. Within that law firm is actually looking for guidance from another lawyer.
Well, I just continue to get constituents who have concerns about the school and the school activities and the use of the name and all of that. And so, you know, as we get information from those attorneys, I think we make the public feel more comfortable and at ease with the situation.
Well, yeah, we're gonna do all we can to protect the interest of our school and our school district in that regard. You know, I mean, if it comes down to have to change the name of the school, we can do that too. So, don't fall out of your chair, Mr. But that's, in my opinion, we need to go as far as we can to protect the interest of the school and not have any conflicts, you know, with regard to the use of that name and the course and the actions and the activities of that school.
Right.
So, that's something that I'm going to try to protect to the best of my ability. And, I just haven't had an opportunity to contact any other attorney that I was referred to yet about that. But I will next week.
Anything else on
the
side?
Okay.
Hearing none, I'll So we'll move to staff reports. Do we have anything to report on Wildlight Elementary?
We're falling, we're going concrete land walk.
Yeah. Coming out of the ground.
Yeah.
Any questions or comments from the board? Okay, then we'll move to the technology update. We have a written update from Mr. Wilson. Hey, I didn't see that. I have to get used to where you all sit now. Most of you used to sit over there, now they're over here. This is a new boardroom for us, and we've only met here a few times, so. Any questions for Mr. Wilson?
No questions, but a comment, Madam Chair?
Yes, ma'am.
As we are updating our website and moving towards full implementation, can we just keep that on our agenda along with technology so we know where we are in the process?
We certainly can.
Thank you.
Anything else on this matter? I'm not aware of any old business, board members? Robin? Thank you, ma'am. Ms. Keurig? If you could state your name and address for the record, you have 3 minutes to address the board.
Ms. Keurig, PLS 15940, Farnaby Beach. And then it's the other one. I am president of Nassau Teachers Association, and I have 3 things tonight. Dr. Roos, thank you so much for giving us new chairs over at the Teen Center. Or maybe it was Kevin, I don't know which. But oh my gosh, they are so much more comfortable.
Kevin.
Bargaining is so much more enjoyable with comfortable chairs.
That was one. Mr. Buchanan, thank you. Every single bus was on time. We had a double stack getting our kids out today. Everybody got on the bus, nobody missed a bus. It was wonderful.
We tried.
Thank you. And then I want to thank Dr. Fogarty and Dr. Burns for bringing up the upward professional movement of our faculty and staff. I have several teachers that I know wish to move up. I'm quite happy where I am right now. But we have some that are extremely qualified, and they would appreciate the opportunities, and I appreciate your recognizing that and bringing it to the forefront. Thank you all very much.
Thank you, ma'am. Dr. Ruth, superintendent's comments?
And I too apologize, Mr. Durham. I had written down, you beat me to it. Well, welcome, and we look forward to working with you. And I know Ms. Morris is actually smiling.
I'm loving it.
I've got a cell phone on me.
Smart man.
I just wanted to talk one thing, Madam Chairman, to make the board aware of. You've heard me mention the STEM 2 Hub organization, which is Northeast Florida Regional Initiative, in working with schools and businesses and corporations with regard to STEM in our area. And there is an organization in Baltimore, the STEM Funders Network, that announced late last week that Northeast Florida has been selected as one of the 10 STEM learning ecosystems to join the STEM Learning Ecosystems Initiative. It's a national initiative that was initially developed in 2015-16. Began with 27 STEM learning ecosystem communities across the United States. Now, the STEM 2 Hub in Northeast Florida is one of 10 that has been selected to be in that learning ecosystem. And I think it's going to help us to continue to expand our opportunities for for our students in the STEM area. So I just want to share that with you. And today was the last day of school, and as everybody's in a hurry to get out of there, so those buses were there on time, and everybody got out, and the teachers were standing there waving at them as they parted, I'm sure. But we had a good opening this year. We had a good closing. So we're primed and in full gear and preparing for next year.
Well, I have a granddaughter that's very disappointed at school. She is very disappointed, and I have a grandson who's cheering. So. We'll move to board comments. Mr. Dionis, would you like to start this evening?
I would like to. Thank you very much. Ms. Morris, you're going to be missed greatly.
Thank you, sir.
It's been a pleasure working with you, and I've got to tell you, being a new board member, I was terrified when Ms. Woods left. I've been spoken to her so many times on the phone and throughout the weeks, and she said, no, Ms. Morris will be just fine. You're going to love her. And no interruptions, seamless. And anyway, it's been a real pleasure working with you. And
I appreciate it.
I hope you won't make yourself scarce. You'll come by and see us. Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. That's all. I'm Chairman. Thank you.
Ms. Cook?
Well, it's two really exciting times are the beginning of the year and the open houses, as we try to get to all of them. And then there is graduation. And Mr. Dionis made a comment last night, as we said at our third this week, that each one of them is unique and different. And it's true. But you still get the feeling that everybody is so excited. And it's just really meaningful to be there, and I enjoy it very much, even though I'm tired right now. The other thing is to thank the faith-based community in this county, because they have held baccalaureates for all of our graduates, and it was comforting to me as a parent to know that my children were walking away from high school, that there were other people praying for them besides me. So that is such a special time, too, to be able to attend the baccalaureate. And then I'm hoping we have a new tradition. I have attended 3 senior walks this year, starting with Yulee. I was at Yulee Elementary School, but they hit Yulee Elementary School and Yulee Primary School at the same time, where the seniors came through in their cap and gown. The elementary and primary students prepared for them with signs. They were high-fiving and everything. And the teachers were seeing some of these kids and going, oh my gosh, they're so big now. And then the last one was
Tuesday.
The last one was Tuesday at Southside. And I've seen pictures posted of several of the seniors that went up and gave a hug to their kindergarten teacher and posted it on Facebook. But so it was the beginning and the end because they were in their cap and gown. So it was very nice. And Rob Hicks posted on there. He said, I didn't know how this was going to go, but it was awesome. So hopefully it will be a new tradition, because I get goosebumps every time, even the third one, because it was just